The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 8th Chapter, Text Number 18, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 10th, 1973, in New York.
Translation. Srimati Kunti says, O Krishna, I offer my obeisances unto you, because you are the original personality and are unaffected by the qualities of the material world. You are existing both within and without everything, yet you are invisible to all.
So, this is the position of God, that He is everywhere. Annantarastham paramanuchayantarastham. He is within this universe, He is within the atom also. Andantarastham paramanucha. Eka pasau rachayatam jagadanna koti jachakti rasti jagadanna chayajadantam andantarastham paramanuchayantarastham govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. This is Brahma Samhita. The Lord, by expansion of one of His plenary portion, He is existing within this universe, not only within the universe, but within the atom also. Anoraniyana mahato mahiya. This is God's qualification, that He can become the greater than the greatest. Just like we have got conception, the greatest, this universe. We cannot even imagine how long, how far it is extended. But such universes are coming out from the breathing of Mahavishnu. Jak karana navajali bhajati isma jugam nidravanantam saromakupam. From His breathing, when He exhales, universes come out, and when He inhales, all those universes again enters. Bhutta bhutta praliya. It is generated and again annihilated. This is going on. This is one side, that universes, innumerable universes, can be put into the nostril hole of the Mahavishnu. And another side, He can enter even within the atom. This is God, consciousness. Anoraniyana mahato mahiya. He is greater than the greatest. We generally say God is great, but we do not know how great He is. People say God is great, but we have no conception how great He is. He is so great that He can swallow innumerable universes within His belly. Just like when Krishna was challenged by His mother, that show me your face. You say that you have not eaten the earth, your friends complain, and you say that you have not eaten, so I want to see, open your mouth. So when you open His heart, all the universes with His mouth, all the universes. He proved, my dear mother, not only little earth, but the whole universe is within my mouth. So when Mother Jasoda was astonished, she thought something illusory. All right, don't do it again. She does not know that here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. To show me His mercy has become my child. She does not know. She always thinks, He is my child. She is under my control. This is the relationship of the Supreme Personality of Godhead with is devotee. This is wanted. Simply to understand God is very great, that is not sufficient knowledge. When you deal with the great, exchange your relationship with the great, that is perfect. That is perfect. Suppose your president is very great. That's all everyone knows. President is very great. But what shall I derive out of that? When I actually deal with him, I become his friend, I become his servant, I become his secretary, I become somewhere or other. If I am related with that great personality, that is my benefit. Otherwise, what is the knowing? Ah, President Nixon is very, there is so many. What I am deriving from that gate? This is Krishna call. The Mayavadi philosophers, they simply remain silent. Oh, God is very great. And they cannot imagine how great he is. But a devotee can understand how great he is. He can see that innumerable universes are within the mouth of God. This is the position of devotee. This is not sufficient knowledge. God is great. God must be great. That's all right. But unless you come in dealing with that great, you cannot relish actually what is God and how great He is. So here Kunti says, Alaksam sarva-bhutanam. Sarva-bhutanam, all living entities, alaksam, you are invisible. Invisible, although antar bahi avasthitam, you are within and without. God is within yourself. Ishara sarva bhutana riddhesho arjuna tishtati. Ishara, the Supreme Lord, is situated in everyone's heart. The yoga system means to see, find out that God, Paramatma, or meditate upon Him. Now the yoga system has come down as bodily exercise to keep the health very good, to reduce fat. This is yoga system. This is not yoga system. This is a bodily exercise. Real yoga is, the God is within me, but He is invisible. Alaksham, antarbahi, although He is within and without, still, I cannot see. So, meditation means concentrating the mind to find out God where He is within my heart. That is real perfection of yoga. So people do not know this science. Here it is nicely explained. The antarbahi avasthitam, the Virat Roop, just like Arjuna wanted to see the gigantic form of God, He showed him. So we can see the gigantic form in this universe. That is described in the Bhagavatam. You have read that the big, big mountains, hills, they are the bones of the gigantic form. They are described, the highest planetary system, Brahma Loka, is the head, how do it is called? Skull? What is this portion? What is the English? This skull. The rivers are the veins, the seas are holes like here we have got. In this way it is all described, the gigantic form. And the gigantic form, at the same time, He is within your heart, very small form. So He is within and without. Simply, we have to purify our eyes to see, that's all. You can see God without and within. But you cannot see with these eyes. These materially contaminated eyes or materially contaminated senses, you cannot understand by these senses. But God can be perceived, can be seen by these senses, by these eyes, when you purify it. That purificatory process is Krishna consciousness. The more you purify, the more you can see God within and without. Atha Sri Krishna Namadi na bhaved graiham indriyai. The indriyai, these senses cannot perceive, cannot see, cannot touch, cannot hear namadi. Unless you are purified, you cannot hear also Krishna name. Unless you are purified, the name enters this ear and goes out in this ear. You cannot appreciate. Therefore, purificatory process is required. People are affected with three kinds of material qualities: goodness, passion, and ignorance. Generally, they are affected by the lower two qualities: ignorance and passion. Rajastama. How do you know that this man is in the modes of goodness, and this man is in the modes of passion, and this man is in the modes of ignorance? How do you know? By the symptom. By the symptom. When one is affected by the lower qualities, rajastama, passion and ignorance, his symptoms are that he is very greedy and lusty. These are the symptoms. As soon as you find a person is very greedy and lusty, he is to be understood under the control of the lower grade qualities of this material nature. And satogun means prakash, illumination. When one is situated in the goodness, that is brahminical quality. Satta, sama, dama, tipikha. He is truthful. He is controlling the mind, controlling the senses, sama, dama, tipikha. He is tolerant. Tipikha, arjava, he is simple, simplicity. Sama, dama, tipikha, suci, he is clean. Jnanam, he knows things, what it is. Vijnanam, he can apply the knowledge in practical life. Jnanam, astikam. Astikam means to have firm faith in God. He knows that God is there. God is there, and he knows that God is within, God is without. These are the symptoms of a person who is in goodness. So these three classes of men are there. The Krishna consciousness movement means to bring persons from the wretched, low qualities, ignorance and passion, to bring him to the platform of goodness. And that goodness also has to be purified. In the material world, the goodness is also attacked by the other lower qualities. Big man, very good man, but there are so many defects. Because unless, first of all, we have come to the platform of goodness, brahminical position, then you have to purify that goodness, sattam visuddham, visuddha satta, vasudeva sabdi. Vasudeva platform. Then he will be able to understand what is God. It is not so cheap thing that one can understand God so easily, while he is in the modes of material nature, especially the lower grade modes. So at the present moment, most people, they are in the lower grades of the material quality. Ignorance and passion. Therefore you see all over the world, rajastama bhava kamalobha, every man is greedy and lust. Every man. So, in this position, it is very difficult. Alaksam sarvabhutana. So unless you change this quality can be changed. It is not that it is stereotype. How these European, American boys and girls, they are coming to Krishna consciousness. How? They change their quality. By the process, we have got this process. In this process, we can change the quality. That process is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Manchabhya vicharini bhakti yogina ja sevati. Sagunan samatitta itan brahma bhuvaya kalpati. Krishna says, one who is engaged in my unalloyed service of bhavichari, no adulteration, pure devotional service. Mancha bhavicharini bhakti yogina ja sevate, one who is engaged in the service of the Lord, purified, unalloyed. Unalloyed means no motive. No motive. Annavilasita sunnam. Other motives completely zero. Generally they go to temple, to church, to or mosque, generally. They go with a motive. Just like in the Christian world. They go that gods must be water supply. We shall pray to God and He must supply. Then I accept God. This is the condition. And if He does not supply my order, I don't care for this God. So they are not going to become servant of God. They want to make God His servant. God give us our daily bread. That's all right. God is giving daily bread. Why you are asking, bothering God? He is supplying food to so millions and trillions of living entities. Why not to you? He will supply. That is not our problem. That God will supply our bread. He is supplying without asking. Do the animals go and to the church and ask for bread? But they are getting sufficient. They are getting sufficient. Therefore, God consciousness does not mean any motive to take from some God, something from God. That is not God consciousness. You give everything to God. That is God. Just like the conception of accepting God as child. That is a better conception to accept God as father. Because from father we simply take away. Father, give me this, give me that, give me that, give me that. And if you accept God as child, then you have to give everything. This is Gaudiya Vaishnava conception. Yashodama. He has accepted his worshipping God as child, so that she is always engaged. The Krishna may not mean any inconvenience about his body, about his comfort, always. Mother Yashoda is anxious that Krishna is now very naughty. He may not capture some monkey, he may not fall down on the water, he may not be burnt in the fire. Always anxious. This is Krishna consciousness. He is always anxious to give protection to Krishna. The best service. Krishna does not require anyone's service. He is complete. Purnam. But pleasing his devotee, he becomes dependent. He is bothering mother, I am hungry, why don't you give me food? I will steal butter, your stock. So this philosophy, Gaudiya Vaishnava philosophy, is very sublime, to accept God as subordinate. Krishna says in Chaitanya Charitamrita, you'll find, there everyone worships me with awe and veneration. But if anyone worships me without any awe, veneration, and treats me as insignificant, I like that. So, that exchange of Krishna's feeling, you can find in this Gaudiya Vaishnava philosophy. That Mother Yashoda is treating Arjuna, Krishna as very insignificant. He is my child. If I don't give him protection, he'll die. Therefore, Krishna is very much obliged to Mother Yashoda. But nobody, everyone comes to God, oh God, you're so exalted. That he's hearing throughout. But when the Mother Yashoda comes and chastises him, he likes it very much. Likes it very much. So, Krishna, although he happened to be nephew of Kunti, Kunti was Krishna's father's sister. But because he was devotee, she knew that Krishna also, although she is playing the part of my nephew, he is the supreme personality of Godhead. Therefore she said, Namaste Purusam Tadyam Isharam Prakite Para. You are Ishara. You are the controller. What kind of controller? There are so many food controller and house controller. This is yoga. No, not that kind of controller. Prakite paro. You are controller. Your position is beyond this material world. Prakite. Prakiti means this material world. Prakite paro. That means these controllers within this material world, they are produced at a certain date and they will be finished at a certain date. These controllers, just like your president, Nixon, he is a controller of your country, but his controlling power is given at a certain date and it will be finished at a certain date. So, Kunti says, you are not that kind of controller. That your controlling power begins at a certain date and finishes at a certain date. That prakite paro. In the prakriti, within the material nature, we have got some controlling power, everyone. But that has the beginning and end. As our life begins and ends, everything here in this material world, it has a beginning and end. But Krishna's controlling power is not like that. She says, Namaste Purusam Adhyam. You are the original person. You have created this cosmos. So, before the creation of the cosmos, you were controller. And when the cosmos will end, you remain controller. Therefore, prakriti form. Within the prakriti, within the material nature, everything has got beginning and end, limited. You are not that kind of controller. Prakriti form. Itana. The another understanding is that because Krishna is controller beyond this material nature, therefore, he is not a product of this material nature. The Mayavadi philosophers, they cannot understand. Their poor fund of knowledge. If God has created this material world, then he must not be anything of this material world. Because before creation he was existing, and after creation, after annihilation, he will remain. Then how he can be anything of this material world? material world, anything, has got a beginning and end. But God is beyond this material world. He was existing. He said, let there be creation. Just like in your Bible, it is said. So there was creation. So how he can be one of the created beings? By his wish, there was creation. But another thing is, then his desires, his wish, they are nothing of this material world. They are spiritual. Prakite para means superior to this material world. In the Bhagavad Gita, you understand, there are two kinds of nature, para and apara. So this material nature is apara, aparayam, itastu vidhime prakitiṃ para, aparayam, bhumi rapanala vayu, the land, water, fire, air, sky, these five elements, they are described in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhinna me prakriti astadha. They are separated energy, inferior quality energy. But beyond this inferior quality energy, I have got another superior quality of energy. What is that? Jiva bhuta. You can understand. The jiva bhuta, the living entity. Jayadam dharjate. Because jiva bhuta, we living entities, we are superior than the matter. Because we are controlling the matter. Just like we have been in the river side, so many things, material things we saw. But who has made it? The living entities. The matter has not come into so many forms without the touch of the living entity. Everyone can understand. The big seeds, how it has come into existence. Because a living entity planned, engineered how to do it, and he brought material things, and he manufactured it. Therefore, these inferior energies, the material things, they are subordinate to the spiritual energy. Therefore, Krishna, when he is prakite para, he is beyond this material nature. His body, his activities, his pastimes, his name, his form, everything, it is not material. Therefore Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, janma karma me dibbam jo janati tattat. If anyone simply tries to understand Krishna as he is, in truth, then he becomes liberated. Simply by understanding Krishna. This is Krishna consciousness. You try to understand Krishna, not by speculation, but as Krishna says, as God says, or a Krishna devotee says, just like one Kunti. Kunti is a devotee of Krishna. She says that you are prakite para. She is authority. She is authority. Because devotee, every devotee, pure devotee, they are confidential. Otherwise, how Krishna has accepted to become her nephew, just like Krishna has accepted to become the son of Jashodamai or Devaki. Similarly, he has accepted to become a nephew of Kunti Devi. This prayer was offered by Kunti when Krishna was taking leave after establishing them, after the battle of Kurukshetra, when everything was settled up. And Krishna was going back to Dwarka. So he came to offer his respects to his aunt Kunti Devi. And when the farewell was taking place, Kunti offered this prayer to Krishna. Namaste, namaste. He happens to be nephew, but he is offering his obeisances. Because he knows he is playing the part of my nephew. But he is the supreme personality of Godhead. Therefore, although she is superior in position, because aunt, she is offering namaste. I offer my respectful obeisance to you. This is the position. So, God is invisible who, for the persons who has no eyes to see Him, alaksham, although He is everywhere. Annantarastham paramanu chayantarastham idam ibisham bhagavan. This visham, this universe, is the transformation of the energy of Krishna. Therefore, the energy is not different from the energetic. Therefore, the whole world is Krishna. Whole world is Krishna. So we have to make our eyes. And that eyes can be purified, as it is stated in the Brahma Sangita. Premanyana churita bhakti bilochanena santa sadaivaridayesu bilokayan. Santa, those who are saintly persons, those who have developed love for God, prema, that anjana, that ointment, who has smeared the ointment of love on the eyes, that then, just like we apply sometimes ointment and surma, what is called in English, surma, just powder or something. Anyway, so when our eyes are cleansed, we think clearly. Similarly, if we apply the ointment of love of God on the eyes, then we can see God. Just like what Krishna, Kunti is seeing. Others, they do not understand that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But the Pandavas and the Pandavas' mother, they know that here is Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. Alaksam. It's like Krishna was exhibiting His Virat Rupa in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, only Arjuna was seeing, nobody else. So, God reveals Himself to the devotee. Although, just like Prahlad Maharaj was seeing that Nrisimhadev has come, and his father ate his father, he was challenging, where is your God? So, God is everywhere, but He is not visible to the non-devotee. But one who is devotee, he can see Him. Every, not only once. Premanyana churita bhakti vilachanena santa sadaiva. Sadaiva means always. He is seeing always Krishna. That is the position of saintly person. Premanyana churita bhakti vilachanena santa sadaiva hridayeshu. Hridayeshu in the heart. Bilokayanti. They see. So, if you can see God, you can talk with God, if you can go back to home, back to God, why should you lose this opportunity? This opportunity is in the human being. You can see God, you can talk with God, you can go back home, back to God. Everything is possible, and that is Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much. Thank you.